Actually, I just wanted to understand my shortwave loop in order to improve it. This video answers many questions from my viewers and myself. Frustrated by the interference on my SDR receiver, I tried a simple loop, a shielded loop and a Möbius loop. My experiments using a cheap test setup were quite successful. I'm posting links to the previous video above. Now I want to better understand the properties of a long and short wave loop so that I can build it correctly dimensioned from solid materials. Thanks a lot for many good comments and great tips from viewers who had similar experience. For example, my tests were showing that the loop's reception is relatively good at low frequencies while it's dropping rapidly at higher frequencies. Tests with a simple, a shielded and a Möbius loop confirmed expectations from the theory. However, there's much more to discover, which we would like to explain clearly today. This video is sponsored by PCBWay, the specialist for PCBs and manufacturing. Guys, here's a dream becoming true for many electronics enthusiasts. Just take a look at what they are offering. It's amazing. Take the easy way with PCBWay. We are investigating magnetic loops with diameters of 4 meters, 2 meters, 1 meter, 50 centimeters and 25 centimeters. Within their operating frequency range, they are significantly smaller than the wavelengths, leading to a radiation characteristic similar to a magnetic dipole. Imagine a radio signal arriving in the main beam direction and sweeping from 10 kHz to 100 MHz. First, we are computing the open circuit voltage the loops are generating across the frequency range. Then we will show the difference it makes using a high impedance preamp instead of a 50 ohm receiver input. And then, also super interesting, we are tuning the loop to resonance with a capacitor. In the final step, we are aiming to understand the properties important for the transmitting case. Our loops with one turn shall have an ohmic resistance of 1 ohm. We are assuming a radio signal's electric field strength of 0.01 millivolt per meter. A loop can be considered as an RF voltage source whose internal resistance is the radiation impedance RS. I found the formula for the open circuit voltage U0 in the famous handbook of high frequency technology by Meinke and Gundlach. It applies to loops that are small compared to the wavelength. U0 is proportional to the electric field strength E, the number of turns N and the area A, but inversely proportional to the wavelength lambda. For our 5 diameters, these are the voltages over the frequency range. The characteristic is shifting further to the right, the smaller the loop. Unbelievable, but unfortunately true. The approximation for the radiation impedance is containing the fourth power of the wavelength. It is very low over a wide range and above a certain frequency, shooting up to the kiloohm range. This, of course, has consequences, as we will see in a minute. This voltage divider is pulling down the receiver input voltage when RS is becoming large. Even though it looks like it, this is not a resonance effect. The falling slope towards higher frequencies is much steeper than towards lower frequencies. The logarithmic frequency axis makes the slope appear similar. If we are using a high impedance preamp, the voltage is increasing because of the reduced load. Fortunately, the usable frequency range is also increasing. We can assess this better on a dBm scale. Here's actually the advantage of a high impedance preamplifier. The ohmic resistance of the loop, in fact the loss, has only small influence in this case, explaining why I was achieving good results with my cheap setup. Adding more turns is increasing the voltage, but the usable frequency is lowering because the radiation impedance is growing quadratically with the number of turns. This is in line to the behavior I observed with my 2 turns Möbius antenna. The voltage source in the equivalent circuit is essentially a coil in which currents and voltages are induced by the magnetic field of the radio signal. Inserting a variable capacitor here, we are obtaining a resonant circuit we can tune to a desired frequency. The resonance effect is causing a stronger signal, as the open circuit voltage is growing by the quality factor Q. In a resonant system, Q is calculated from the ratio of the energy stored to the loss during each oscillation. In our electrical resonant circuit, the energy oscillates between the inductance and capacitance and is consumed by the radiation resistance and the ohmic resistance of the loop. When calculating the inductance L, R is the radius of the loop and A is the radius of the conductor cross-section. The ratio of stored energy to loss equals the ratio of inductive reactance to the resistances mentioned. Since RS is low in the usable range, the loss is mainly determined by the ohmic resistance, which is the reason it should be as low as possible in a resonant loop. By the way, the capacitor should be of high quality as well. Otherwise, Q will be small, meaning the resonance effect is poor. At its resonant frequency, a loop is delivering stronger signals compared to the non-resonant case. But you can also make it worse in the upper frequency range, as can be seen here. Assuming we are tuning to all frequencies in the range, we would get these signal strengths. A high impedance preamp cannot improve unless we have to compensate for losses in a long feeder cable. Now comes the transmitting case. The efficiency E corresponds to the radiated power divided by the total transmitted power, or the ratio of the effective resistances. Note how narrow the frequency range with high efficiency is. So you need suitable loops for different frequency ranges. At very low frequencies, poor efficiency is sometimes acceptable. The logarithmic representation shows the low range better. How are antenna properties actually affecting the radio range? Feeding 1 watt to the loops, we are computing the distance R where they would generate the field strengths that we considered for the reception case. We explained this in more detail in earlier videos. The range in free space is a theoretical maximum, but it's giving you an idea of what you can achieve. The work was intended to help me dimensioning longwave and shortwave loops. But it's also answering questions such as the rapid drop in the upper frequency range and the benefit of a preamp or a resonant loop with high Q. At low frequencies, a large wire loop is already a good solution. A high impedance preamp is extending the range and significantly improving the performance at higher frequencies. A resonant loop is providing stronger signals and usually higher interference immunity through its selectivity. However, to achieve high Q, we need high quality materials. We will certainly experiment with all the concepts, having an eye on reducing interference on my SDR receiver. We will talk about balloons and details of the shielded and Möbius loop in a separate video. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.